Lawyer, war veteran, and former ABS-CBN Vice Chairman Augusto Jake Almeda Lopez has passed away at 95. Lopez joined the Lopez Group as head of ABS-CBN's personnel division in 1961 and led the company's name change from the Bulinao Electronics to ABS-CBN Broadcasting Corporation in 1967. He also served on the board of several Lopez Group companies and formally retired in 2008. In a statement, ABS-CBN expressed its heartfelt condolences to his family. The company also recognized his efforts with his many years of building and rebuilding the network alongside its founder, Capitan Henny Lopez, who called Jake the soul of the organization. The Philippine entertainment industry mourns the passing of Deo Endrinal, the head of ABS-CBN's Dreamscape Entertainment. Endrinal was 60 years old. He was a producer, a writer, and a creative director who produced a string of hit television series, including classics like Gimmick, Mula sa Puso, and the recent FPJ's Ang Probinsyano and Batang Quiapo. He also headed other iconic entertainment shows such as ASAP and The Buzz.
He's a visionary and a genius, pero more than sa trabaho, mas hanga ako sa kanya, sa person, kasi isa siyang epitome ng kung paano tumrato ng mabuti sa kapwa-tao and hindi lang bilang isang katrabaho but bilang isang tao.
My best memories in ABS are with Sir Deo and my projects with him. I will never forget the roles that that he made me play. He was my angel. Sinuportahan niya ako for many years. He trusted me, he believed in me.
A spy action comedy and a historical drama are some of Hollywood's newest offerings. Our resident movie critic, Manny the Movie Guy, tells us which one is his favorite.
I certainly hope you dance as well as you dress.
Spies, double crosses, and Dua Lipa making her big screen debut in Argyle. The saying, write what you know, comes to play in this spy action comedy that is overlong and overwrought that you would long for the film to be over. From Matthew Vaughn, the guy who gave us the Kingsman movies, this is sort of an offshoot of the Kingsman films, which will be revealed near the end.
But what happens next?
Bryce Dallas Howard is Ellie Conway, a reclusive best-selling spy author who finds herself in a real-life espionage seemingly lifted from the pages of her novels.
You're Ellie freaking Conway.
Great cast, great premise, but poorly executed, Argyle is a spy thriller with unnecessarily convoluted twists and turns. And for that, Argyle gets 2 out of 4, not worth your time and money, kisses. And in limited release, there's The Promised Land. Mads Mikkelsen is an impoverished war hero in 18th century Denmark who will do anything to tame a vast, uninhabitable land. I caught up with the actor at the Palm Springs International Film Festival last month, where the film had its premiere.
So he wants to be part of something that he actually hates. He hates nobility. So it's a very complex character.
This is old school filmmaking at its finest, with your emotion as its target. Simply riveting. And for that, The Promised Land gets 3.5 out of 4. Promise kept. Kisses. And on streaming, catch up on Moving on Disney Plus and Hulu.
Kim Dushik, Amomyong Bunsan.
The story of 3 high school students with superhuman abilities is simply one of the best superhero series around. It follows the superhero tropes, but it's a story well told. Big credit goes to director N.J. Park.
I was really, taken by it emotionally and really wanted to dive into it.
Dive into Moving. The 20-episode series is a bit violent, but for every drop of blood comes swelling emotion. And for that, Moving gets 3.5 out of 4. Stream it now. Kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ABS-CBN News.